South America, a continent steeped in history of historical history. Machu Picchu, Nazca, Tongariki. But there was one sacred site that had baffled archaeologists for decades. Las Ruinas de Bolas, mystical, spiritual, ancient, old. But this treasured site was won in a game of cards by a mean hombre called Jesus. He bulldozed the lot and built something bigger and better and not as historical. Sorry. Tonight, 20 plucky Brits, including a zookeeper, a librarian and an Olympian's wife, have journeyed to Argentina to do battle on that hallowed ground. One will return home with £10,000 of treasure. The other 19 will just come home. Welcome to Total Wipeout, a fun-filled extravaganza of foam and falling. Or if you've just switched over from BBC Four, it's a discourse on the fugacity of perpendicularity in the contemporary game show milieu. Or if you've just switched over from BBC Three, it's a real sick ting, bless up fam. Here's what today's contestants are about to face. The Qualifier, brutal but funny. Double Cross, even more brutal but no less funny. Terrogoran, getting pretty serious, still funny. And the Wipeout Zone. Hey, it's your lounge, you can giggle if you want to. That's the explanation side of things out of the way. Time now for the unexplanation side. That can't be right. It's just time for the side directly opposite the explanation side of the many-sided thing of, look, can I start again?
Joining me now and ready to do battle against the qualifier is Tom from Norwich, who's a business analyst.
Yeah, and a pretty angry one at that, I'd say.
Yeah.
Now, Tom, are you an actual Viking?
Yeah, we go to festivals and we will feast and we drink and we make merry long into the night.
Do you spend time flexing your muscles by polishing your horns on your helmet?
Yes, all the time. I've got the shiniest helmet around.
Oh no, he's broken his axe, look.
By the mighty hammer of Thor, I shall prevail!
I'm a little bit scared of Tom.
Don't be scared, he's not a real Viking, or is he? Nothing to worry about anyway, without his axe, he's just a big softie. 26-year-old Tom giving it a good go up on the pontoons. But all this could change when he encounters today's first obstacle, which is brand new. An exotic combination of red and blue foam and a few wobbly bits. Contestants must leap from one hurdle to the next, avoiding the hidden springs. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the... what do you mean it hasn't got a name?
This is awkward, but brilliant. I'm going to name it. I hereby christen this obstacle... the Hammond Hurdles.
But how will Tom the Viking fare on this fiendish new obstacle? Well, he's made it across. In fact, he made that look easy. Woo! Yeah, contestant one, Hammond Hurdles, nil. Next, it's the sucker punch. Wall, mud, fists, squirty work. Simple as that. Oh, knock to the jaw. Oh, he's as hard as nails, though, isn't he?
It's not very Viking-like, is it?
So, Tom the Viking battles on up the ramp towards the big red balls. They're big, they're bouncy, and they're hard to cross. There's no hanging about because the demotivator could kick in at any moment. Tom grits his Viking teeth, takes a running Viking leap, and with a Viking cry, falls off. Which of he wasn't wearing his helmet, that wouldn't have helped, would it? No matter, with the clock still ticking, Tom makes his way to the final obstacle. It's not the ladder, it's the shapeshifter that follows. Like a seaside Ferris wheel, it goes round and round and occasionally breaks down. There's no sitting back and enjoying the view though, just a bounce onto the all-new trampette and a dive through the cutout of your choice to the finish podium. Easy peasy,
for us. We're sitting here watching. So, steely nerves jangling, Tom the Viking sets forth safely onto the trumpet. Now comes the difficult bit. Which shape is he going for? It's the triangle! He's in! He needs to get out. Ow! But what a great finish! Even though it's without a face.
You went for that hell for leather.
For honour and glory. Earned my place in Valhalla. Yeah!
Next is 31-year-old Cass. She's a primary school teacher from Brighton. I think. Kaz on the pontoons. Yes, come on! Okay, Hammond hurdles, ahoy! Here we go, yes, 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 yes-ish. No, not at all. Doing their job nicely there, you see? And there's more to come. Gordon, indeed. Come on, Kaz, you can do it. Here we go, yes, a little unsteady. And she's over. Yeah, it might be easier if you kept the chat down. She's not stopped talking all the way around. Chit-chat Kaz to the shapeshifter. Safely onto the trampette. Timing her jump now. Atomic. Yeah, that could have damaged the vocal cords.
Yeah!
Yeah!
I've done it!
Yeah, you did!
Oh,
yeah, we saw!
It.
Yeah!
Oh. I wonder who she's actually talking to. Herself. She's still going. Uh-huh.
Okay, you can be quiet now. This is Kim from Newport. She's a librarian. No. I said librarian. Sorry.
Hi, Kim.
That wasn't awkward at all. Silence steps now onto the Hammond hurdles. Silence is golden, and her tights are golden as well. Well, they were.
Not now.
Just hope that's the sound of her tights ripping, and not like tendons. Sorry, just saying. Proceeds silently to the big red balls. Oh, almost demotivated. Ball one. Transferred to ball two and three. Oh, hang on. Oh, no, at last she's making some noise and falling off.
Did you see her face?
Yeah. Oh, dear. Shapeshifter for shush now, Kim. Onto the triangle. And jump. Jump now. Come on, jump. Yes!
And it is. Happy ending.
Kim completes the qualifier in 3 minutes, 55.
And more, yes! Woo!
Yeah, it sounds like she's broken
yes!
the seal.
Woo!
Who's next? Ah, yes, Pete. Pete the volunteer ranger from Plymouth. Look at this guy, he could win it.
I'm powerful Pete, and I'm the one to beat.
Yeah, I still think he could win it. Okay. Being a ranger, Pete will be used to challenging situations on the range. Okay, let's come back to Power Ranger Pete. Give him time to adjust. This is Siobhan, a nurse from Manchester. Mind the step there.
So, Siobhan. Oh, you're excited. Well, I'm scared.
No, she's only bluffing. Right, Hammond Hurdles. This is a good name. Oh, step back, not a good start. That way, yes. Come on you go. Yes, yes. Oh, yes, no. She wasn't bluffing at all. No.
Huh?
Tell you what, let's get back to Pete. Great, he's on the big balls. About time he had a ball crosser. Will this 66-year-old Power Ranger do it like I know he can? Yes. No. Not at all. It doesn't matter how old you are, a faceplant is just a slip and a stumble away. It's just a fact. Not for everyone. Obviously. But for Power Ranger Pete, yes. Power Ranger Pete hauls himself up onto the final obstacle. And it's not a bad time so far. Oh, hang on. He's going for the jump. Oh! Aimed high, went low. He's 66. That's not, you know, oh. Power Ranger Pete comes home in 3 minutes, 9 seconds. I really hope he qualifies.
You have proved your point that OAPs can definitely do it just as well as the young ones.
Oh, exhausting. Absolutely exhausting.
Now, Total Wipeout is all about preparation, and a big part of that is good nutrition. You've got your four major food groups: meat, veg, pudding, and after-dinner mince. But I've always wondered whether you really need all of those to beat Total Wipeout. How would, say, a vegan get on compared to, oh, I don't know, a carnivore?
This is Victoria. She's 39 years old, she's a model, and she's nuts about nuts.
You're a vegan?
I am, yes. And I was voted Europe's sexiest vegetarian. And I'm hoping now to be the world's sexiest vegan.
And this is Stephanie, who's also a model. Interests include eating meat, playing the violin, and boxing in a leotard. Wow!
I just had a fight not so long ago. It was Models Fight Night, and I won.
This should be interesting. Let the battle commence. Okay, not what I was expecting. She's off, and at some speed too. Here come the hurdles. Something to get her teeth into. No teeth, just face. Is it me, or did she forget to get dressed? Did nobody think to tell her?
Oh, hello.
Okay, the second set now. Really going for the kill. Oh, cheeky! You see?
Oh.
Okay, Vic the vegan now.
Vegans rule! Vegans are the future! Vegan power!
Come on, Vicky! Come on, Vicky!
Oh!
Taking it steady. That's too steady. That's better. Oh! Right, now getting onto the pontoon. This is taking a while.
Go for the vegetables!
Brilliant, nothing like a bit of veg encouragement. Onto the Hammond hurdles. Cautious. Yes. Yes. No, no, don't do that. Don't do that. Falls like a sack of potatoes. That's got pulled muscles written all over it. Yeah, that'll be the corned beef sandwich I dropped in there earlier. Sorry, you should have kept your mouth shut. Okay, hurdles, take two. Come on, Vicky, use that vegetable power. Oh no! Sucker punch now. I'm not sure it's socially acceptable to punch a vegan, is it? Squirting them with cabbage juices, that's fine. Oh.
Rubbish, shall we go to the pub?
She'll be pleased to know that that mud really is organic. I mean, really organic. Vampish Steph is onto the blood red balls. She jumps onto the first, onto the second. Keep those fangs away from the rubber. If it bursts, you'll zip about the rest of the course at a million miles an hour. Onto the third. Ooh, yes. No. Went wrong so quickly, didn't it? Vampish Steph steaming ahead to the final obstacle. Must be all the weight saving she's made by wearing basically nothing. She's going for it! And she got it, right in the face. The vamp reaches the finish in a very respectable 2 minutes 43. Whilst Vic the vegan lost out in this battle with a time of 5 minutes 35.
Woo!
Let's take a look at the leaderboard. With 7 contestants down, Tom the Viking has pillaged his way to top spot, whilst Vampish Steph and Power Ranger Pete are in second and third. Chit Chat Kaz is in fourth, while Shush Now Kim and Scaredy Cat Siobhan are in fifth and sixth. Vic the Vegan languishes in seventh, but that could all change. Time for some more contestants. Kirsten from Watford. She's a zookeeper. Hooray! Yep, you can see why she got the job.
I'm gonna smash through this course like a charging rhino.
Okay. Kirsten, that's more like a shuffling sloth. Now you need to be a jumping kangaroo. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, no, now a swimming sea turtle. I like them, sea turtles. Kirsten on the shapeshifter.
Jump and leap. Flying monkey.
You know they don't fly, don't you? An eagle, they're better. Yes. Yes, there she goes. There she went. On the plus side, a perfectly timed jump to get through the hole. On the negative side, the trajectory was entirely wrong. And Kirsten seals, he seals the deal. I thank you. This is Glenn, an IT specialist with a passion for fashion.
So Glenn, what's so geeky cheeky about you then?
Oh, I love clothes. I design my own, like this one.
I would never have guessed that, Glenn.
Oh, you love it.
Okay. Glenn's outfit was designed to make him streamlined, light on his feet, and quite a mover. Hold on, he's not wearing the suit. Probably dry clean only, yeah. Still, I have every faith in Glenn. You don't need a power suit. Look at this, see? Oh, oops, spoke too soon. Glennie Glitter may be able to sew sequins onto all-in-one outfits, but can he clear the big balls? Oh, no, he can't. That's surprising. Sequin sewers are normally so good at the big balls, the two skills are pretty much interchangeable. Ah, who's this? Nice bunny hat. And it belongs to 22-year-old Daniel from Liverpool. He's a B-boy.
So, Daniel, tell me, what on earth is a B-boy?
Well, B-boy is sort of a breakdancer.
What kind of breakdancing is it like?
Just really old school.
Yeah, I know all these moves. Backspin, hand glide, Charleston. Yeah, I do it all. Right, off goes bunny boy Daniel. Underwater. But the bunny hat stays on. That's some incredible hat-wearing skills. It's a good start. OK, bunny boy, spring over these hurdles. Who is doing it? Across the first set. And Daniel clears the second set too. Yeah, bunny boy to the sucker punch. Oh, check out these moves. Oh, rabbit punch. But it didn't knock the hat off, did it? Well, this will be the test. Big balls. Watch the hat closely. Let me jump one. Oh. Oh, the hat's gone as well. It's just all gone wrong. Being bunny hatless is not stopping Daniel, though he hops home in 2 minutes 40.
Now, whilst not every Total Wipeout contestant is talented at obstacle course crossing, some of them do have other talents, like music. And it's for that reason I've been workshopping the idea of a Total Wipeout pop band. Daniel, who was just on, he can be the backing dancer. Obviously, I'll be in the band on jazz flute. This one's broken. Now, while I can see the appeal of a flute-slash-b-boy dancer combo, this band probably needs some other members to maximise the commercial appeal.
Band member 3, on rap duties straight out of London, it's Ian.
I'm the man with the master plan, so hey, let's get this on. What do you say?
Well, nothing just yet.
So, Ian, what makes you so smooth and good with your words?
Well, Amanda, you know, back in the days, I used to be a rapper, was involved in a rap group. Our major claim to fame was we got signed by a record company, but we only released one record.
Oh.
Doesn't matter, you're still in the band.
Peace.
Next, on lead vocals, it's Sarah from Liverpool. She's in an ABBA tribute band.
Let me guess, hang on. Benny? Bjorn? Oh, Bjorn.
Definitely, yeah.
No, I don't think she's actually from Sweden. And completing the lineup, from Edinburgh, it's Graham. Can it's no need ever, no need ever, no more, while I play Total Wipeout. Definitely in. I christened this band weird direction. What a lineup! We're gonna be huge. World, prepare yourselves, because Notorious IAN is about to rock the mic.
I am the man with the master plan on top. Start again, let's do it again.
Well, give him a chance, it's early days, come on.
So right now, I'm feeling really mean, and I'm ready to go, because I'm just keen. Peace.
Yeah, right, enough of the peace, time for some war. Oh, no, that looked nasty. Can I get a rewind? Now, here's not Swedish Sarah.
I am the dancing queen, and today, the winner takes it all! Woo!
Off she goes.
The winner takes it all!
Ow! At least she's in sync with Ian. This is good working together. Okay, time for Graham McBanjo. Clever, you see, you can't fall down if you're already sitting, can you?
He's got a funny looking run, hasn't he?
Amanda, don't insult members of my band. Good work, Graham.
Yes!
Looking good, fella. On to the second set. Oh, I hope he hasn't hurt his plucking fingers. No, they're working.
I cross the equator and he's 45.
Notorious IAN onto the hurdles. What's his name? Check yourself in, but don't wreck yourself. It's okay, he's all right. He's all right. Second set now. Yeah, step, step, step. Oh, right in the beatbox. What's the name of the game, Sarah? Sucker Punch. Oh.
Oh, Mamma Mia.
Yep, here we go again.
Mamma Mia, here I go again.
Sarah to the big balls, but which ABBA pun will Amanda utilise next?
Take a chance.
Textbook stuff.
I have a dream.
Sadly, though, that wasn't. Banjo Man, Big Balls, what a combo. Go on, Graham. Oh, no, never mind. Can't be brilliant at everything. Notorious IAN, time for an encore. Ow! Oh, folded up.
I think he just broke the deck.
Yeah, as long as he can still spit rhymes and say, what's up, I don't care. Not Swedish Sarah comes home in 3 minutes 39. And Graham McBanjo comes in quickest. Well done, everyone. Take 5.
Ding, 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 ding. Where's my banjo anyway? Is that Richard Harris calling?
Did he just call me Richard Harris? Richard Harris? I am offended. Plus, he actually accused me of stealing his banjo, and that technically is unforgivable. Who are you?
I'm Richard Harris. Have you seen Graham? I've got his banjo.
Leaderboard? Yeah.
So, Tom the Viking still sits atop the pile with Graham McBanjo and Glennie Glitter in second and third. Bunny Boy Daniel in fourth and Zookeeper Kirsten in sixth. Power Ranger Pete falls to 8th place and Not Swedish Sarah slots into 10th. 7 contestants still to go. Who's next? It's Nick from Devon and he really likes dinosaurs.
What's this dinosaurs business? Do you look for dinosaur bones?
Oh, professor in dinosaurs, how cool would that be? Ooh,
that would be really cool, I think.
There's nothing wrong with liking dinosaurs. My favourite is the Brontosaurus. I like the neck and the... They look nice.
If you could choose one dinosaur, Nick, that you could channel out there on the qualifier today, what would that be?
I think I'd probably be a pterodactyl. Terror of the skies. I'm going to fly around this course today.
Oh, great. Fly, Nick, fly. Nickodactyl starts his challenge. Oh, he'll be dinosaur after that. Thank you. Right, Nickodactyl, onto the sucker punch now. Oh yeah, right in the Jurassics. Maybe that's why the dinosaurs became extinct. Boom, boom, boom. Gonna shoot you right down. Nick's got so much mud on him, he's in danger of being fossilized. Right, here he goes. Oh, amazing slip. Nickodactyl versus the shapeshifter. That sounds like a monster movie. And one I definitely watch. Right, here comes the big jump.
Look at him fly!
He's on. Unbelievable. He's off. Entirely believable. And Nickadactyl hoists himself home in 2 minutes, 12 seconds.
Come on.
This is Liam. I'm not sure where he's from. He's trying to tell me. Hemel Hempstead? From Aberystwyth.
Alright, me babbers, these me daps mine. Cheers, drive.
Yeah, that's Bristol. Definitely Bristol. Because in Bristolian, daps means trainers. Let's hope he doesn't get them wet. Hurdles now. Plows over, beating those hurdles. Here we go. Yes. Ooh, hard landing. Could Liam be our first ball crosser today? Do you know what? I've got a feeling he's going to do it. One, two. Oh, no. No, he's only gone and got his daps wet, hasn't he? Nevertheless, Dapsy Liam completes the qualifier in an impressive 1 minute 47.
It's time now for me to say zdravo kakosi to today's next challenger. This is Maya, who's from Bosnia via Worthing. And that was hello, how are you in Bosnian, wasn't it?
Zdravo, ja nisam znala da pričaš bosanski. Možemo ovaj intervju na bosanskom onda ako hoćeš.
It says here Maya is a scientist. Her colleagues call her the Mad Bosnian. I don't know why. Okay, Maya to the sucker punch. Oh, sneaky bottom row blow. Yeah, just a muddy mad scientist now. The big balls now. Here we go. Oh, no. That's an experiment she probably won't forget. Two minutes 49, though. Let's hope it's enough to qualify. Still four contestants to go.
It's time now for me to say a big hello to a little lady called Lisa, who's married to what we would call on Total Wipeout a legend, Olympic decathlete Dean Macy, who smashed a few records around here lately.
Dean set an all-time record on the qualifier and stormed to victory in the Wipeout Zone.
What does Dean think of lovely Lisa's chances?
Oh, he thinks I'm going to rip through the course.
Yeah, baby!
I think so anyway.
So if Lisa's married to an Olympian, I guess that makes her an Olympian-in-law? Yeah. The Olympian-in-law begins. Ooh, yeah! I can't remember Dean Macy doing anything that impressive. Magnificent. Okay, the hurdles. Yes, yes, Lisa's across the first slot. This is amazing. Great legwork. Look at this.
Oh, yes.
So an action roll at the end and everything. Now for the balls. Come on, Lisa. Remember what your hubby taught you. Jump, skip, jump, land. It's that easy. Okay, here she goes. Ready? Jump, skip, fly. Oh, swim. Yeah, look how fast she went. And off the second ball, too. Lisa now looking a little drenched. Better out than in, fair enough, you know. Come on, Lisa, this is a great time. Onto the trampet. Amanda's speechless, that's rare. Lisa waits till everything's lined up. Come on, girl, do it for the nation. Proud moment, we are all with you. No, oh, never mind, no. Still, Lisa's the fastest woman today, well done. This is Phil, and this is Liam. They're partners, except for today, of course, because here, they're rivals. Phil's been training for months, and Leo's been practicing this stare for months. But now they've travelled to Argentina to find out which of them is the best.
Now, Phil, you're going to have to help me out here today, because Leo here was born deaf, and my signing skills aren't exactly what they used to be, I'm afraid. Now, Leo, how do you rate Phil's chances?
Maybe.
Okay, stop that now. Please don't hurt him before the course starts. That's not the idea.
At the end of the day, who do you think is going to come out on top?
You.
That means power to deaf people. Leo's given the signal to start. Oh, that was a hefty blow. It seemed to have bothered Leo too much, though. He's up and under the pontoons and looking like he means business. The Hammond hurdles now. Woo-hoo! Awesome work. This is a great start. So, has Phil got the skills to thrill?
Leo may be quicker, stronger and faster than me, but I'm going to wipe off this core!
Yeah, you've just said he's better in every single way. OK, good luck. Good attitude, Phil. Or bad slip. Phil has been a fireman for 7 years, so he should be in pretty good shape. Will he cross the Hammond hurdles as well as Leo? No, no. I love these hurdles, they're really entertaining for us. Leo now gunning for the big balls, going at jet speed too. Whoa! 360 degree slip, rarely seen, always good when we do see it though. So an opportunity for Phil to make up some ground here. One, two. Oh, fireman down. Final obstacle for Leo, and he's making pretty good time. Not hanging about, he's onto the triangle. And kind of holding on. Clear! Leo beats the shapeshifter and finishes in the fastest time so far today, making him Leo the leader.
Oh my God!
He may not be able to match Leo's time, but can Phil match his magnificent effort? No, not really.
Oh, Philly! Was so silly.
Yeah, you say silly, I say spectacular.
I didn't mean to hurt you. I'm just
he took some knocks, but Silly Philly completes the qualifier in 2 minutes, 9 seconds. What a qualifier. Only one contestant left. Can it get any better? Yes, it can. This is Sophia.
Now, how do you keep your delicious bod in shape, woman?
I do a lot of sports, trampolining a lot for 11 years. Enough, I've got my own trampoline, so.
The next question then is, Sophia, do you know how you're gonna get to the very end of the qualifier?
I think I'm just gonna bounce my way across.
Yep, check out that springing action. Okay, Sophia, bounce your way across these. Solid landing from the gravity thing there. Okay, stepping across, that's good. Done for the third. Oh!
Oh dear, I think she just broke the cert.
She broke my Hammond hurdle. However, we've started this, so we will finish. It'll be worth it to see this trampolinist in action. This now is familiar territory. Okay, bounce-o-meter's at the ready. I'm expecting something great. This is her territory now. That was rubbish. Not a single bounce across the course.
Been trampolining a lot for 11 years.
I feel so shortchanged.
Bounce my way across.
Yeah. Non-bouncy Sophia finishes in 4 minutes 43, which sadly bounces her out of the top 12. Can't believe she broke my hurdle. I spent ages naming that. Right then, the final qualifier leaderboard sees Leo the leader at the top with Tom and Liam close behind. Silly Philly's in 5th and Bunny Boy Daniel's in 8th. Zookeeper Kirsten scrapes through in 12th. For the other 8 contestants, it's time to say cheerio. Or, if you will, toodle pip.
Oh, I had the time of my life, and I never felt this way before. And I swear this is true, and I owe it all to you.
I'm never going to forget those guys. The tall one, that girl with the hair, and was one of them called Bobby or Bobo? Anyway, with their names etched forever in my heart, it's time to move on. Sort of there. Now, it's very easy for me to sit here and laugh at people falling off things. Now, really, it is, which is why I'm going to continue doing just that. It's double cross. As the
name suggests, there are two crosses. The first has four walkways, three green, one red. The contestants must enter using a green walkway and exit on the red. The second cross is the annoying one. If you're too slow, it'll hit you in the legs, head, or bottom. First six to get across progress to the Terragorand. Qualifying in first and fourth place, it's Leo and Phil. That's what you fell for.
Leo said that he beat me in the first round and he's going to beat me in the second. We'll see. Come on!
Okay. Next up and second on the qualifier, it's Tom the Viking.
Hammer time!
What happened to the helmet?
Anyway, in third and fourth place, it's Dapsy Liam and Graham McBanjo.
We may win and we may lose. That's
right. Stick to the banjo, mate. You're good at that. In sixth place on the qualifier, it's Glennie Glitter. Followed by Nickadactyl and Bunny Boy Daniel.
Hagen Bane! Woo!
He really does struggle with his hats, doesn't he? Yeah. Leading the girls in eighth place, it's Olympian in-law Lisa, followed by Vampish Steph.
Go, fight, win!
In 11th place is Mad Scientist Maya.
What am I doing here?
Be late for instructions. And clawing away into the final spot is Zookeeper Kirsten.
I'm used to cleaning up after animals, and I'm going to clean up on this round.
Okay, here we go.
It's turned into a rather soggy day. Not quite as soggy as this lot are going to get after Double Cross gets its paws on them. Are you all ready?
Yeah!
That's what they think. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes, more like. Right, who'll be first? Come on, somebody give it a go. It's Dapsy Liam. Ow, painful. Leo runs. He's on. He's in the middle.
Leo is a genius.
Glennie Glitter. No, he's gone. Graham steps on and steps straight off again. Tom, no. Vampy Steph, shocking. Here's Silly Philly, that was just silly. Nickadactyl, this is chaos. Bunny Boy Daniel, straight into the water. Leo's still on his own in the middle, ignoring the madness all around him. Oh no, hang on, he's going for it. So close, but that stumble cost Leo one serious face plant. And I would imagine some front teeth. Graham McBanjo swimming. Says Daniel. Maya has a go. No. Then he's glitter. Leo's off again. This man just makes it look so easy. A little reposition there. Oh! Yes, he's on the red gangway, and Leo the leader is through. Really is living up to his name, and with that, he's one leap closer to the final. Five places left. Silly Philly, looks like he wants one. Yes, he's into the middle. Bit of encouragement from Leo. Oh, Graham takes a blow there. Clutching onto that sweeper like his precious banjo. Tom looking ready. He's going to go for it. So's Daniel. They're both dead. Phil now going for it. And he just missed it. Tragedy. Phil's second attempt and second smack on the head too. Liam's on the centre now. Nickadactyl making a run for it and joins him in the middle. We just need to wait for that red gangway. Graham, again pushed out by that sweeper arm. Oh, Liam goes. Whoopsie dapsy. Looks and sounds like he really didn't want to do that. That's primal, basic stuff. Still five places left. Kirsten the zookeeper. Doing a very good seal impression. Oh dear, there's Tom. Pillaging his way to the middle. Just needs some room, but Nick's not budging. Here comes Phil. That makes three. All getting very cozy up there. Someone should probably go now on that red exit ramp. Here's Bunny Boy Daniel. in the mix. This is getting interesting and crowded.
Wow, this is a very dark time.
Oh, hello, Vampish Steph wants some action. And she got it. Looking rather crowded up there now. And here's Silly Philly again. He's moving and he's over. And reunites with Leo.
Aww. Join together in holy wipeouting.
Who will be next? Tom. No. Daniel. He's going to do it. Oh, so close. No, it really happened. A new breakdancing move from Bunny Boy there. A broken dancing, more really. That's left the way clear for Tom the Viking. And he's across. He joins Leo and Phil in the next round. Nick still in the middle. Ooh, but he's been joined now by Dapsy Liam. Doesn't look very happy about it. Hasn't actually moved from the middle yet, though. Graham McBanjo tries his luck again. Makes it to the middle-ish. Maybe he does love clinging to those giant sweepers. And that spurred Steph on, who joins the action in the centre.
Oh, that's not an angle I want to see this from.
No, nothing we haven't seen before. We have a lot of bottoms on seats. Someone needs to go. Snickerdactyl. Yes! No! Less flying pterodactyl, more lumbering stegosaurus. Kirsten running like a lemur. But it's worked and she's on. Good to see the girls going for it. Which urges Maya on too. Vampy Steph, Cozy Wet. Ray McBanjo, so close. Yes, there's Olympian in law Lisa. They're all waiting for that red gangway. And here's Bunny Boy Daniel. No breakdancing, just running. He's through. He does look quite pleased with himself, and rightly so. Only two places left, and there's not much room up there. Glenn making a charge. And now they're all on. This is incredible.
It's the first time this has ever happened, that they have all been on the middle of Double Cross at one time.
It doesn't look too comfortable, really. So fighting for the last two places are Maya, Nicodactyl, Lisa, Dapsy Liam, Graham McBanjo, Glennie Glitter just holding on, Zookeeper Kirsten and Vampish Steph. All just waiting for the red gangway. Here goes Maya, and she's made it. Yes! Well done, Maya. So we have a girl in the next round. And she does scream like one. Definitely a girl. Yeah. One place left now. Must be feeling the pressure. Who will take that last place? It'll be Dapsy Liam. No, no. Who's going to be next? Nicodactyl taking a chance, and it's worth it because he's through. And that is the six Terra-Go-Randers, which means Double Cross is all over, and it's farewell to the defeated.
I'm really disappointed. I wanted to be the first girl again. When Maya got through, I felt like crying in the middle.
It's sad, but I guess this is not my time. No Shazam, no Kaboom.
Devastated, because I knew I could do it, and it just feels as if I've let people down.
I mistimed a few things there. I think Leo's the man at the moment. He's got the skill and the timing.
I'm really happy that Phil and Leo have got through, and I really hope that they do well in the next round.
I think my outfit helps a lot because everybody else is freezing in wet clothes, and I've got my swimming costume on already.
Let's look at the stats. Right, that's the stats looked at. What should we look at next? A podium. Okay. Well, that's enough looking at things for one day. Time for the Terra-Go-Round.
That's the Terra-Go-Round. Those are the contestants. The contestants go round on Terra-Go-Round until they fall off. This week's projectile theme is lost luggage, so the Terra Twins will be hurling excess baggage to distract the contestants. There are three heats. The last contestant standing in each goes through to the Wipeout Zone.
I've seen some pretty terrifying things in my time, let me tell you, but this is the most terrifying of them all. It's Terra Go Round. Are you ready? Yeah! should be terrified. 3, 2, 1.
So before things get started, let's remind ourselves who's taking on the mighty Terror Go-Round. He's a little bit silly.
Come on!
It's Silly Philly. Hoping to pillage the course.
I shall prevail!
It's Tom the Viking. 65 million years in the making. It's Nick Adapter. Fastest all day. It's all in the name. It's Leo the Leader. Some say she's crazy. I'd say demented. It's Mad Scientist Maya. And finally, it's the old school B-boy himself.
That's really old school.
Bunny Boy Daniel. I've no idea where today's lost luggage was sourced from. Maybe it actually belongs to the contestants. Anyway, steady there, Daniel. Okay, unleash the baggage. Case, cardboard box, my duty free. The guys are still on their feet, though. Oh, right on the buns.
Nothing like a suitcase in the face. Hate it when that happens.
Not as bad as a giant teddy bear, anyway. Okay, time for the pickled fingers. Get ready for the chaos. Oh, my goodness, he's taken 5 of them down.
I think we have a clear winner.
Leo the Leader. He's done it again. A great effort. Oh, mind your toe. Leo hurdled over the fickle fingers whilst the others, well, they didn't stand a chance. See, they don't call them the fickle fingers for nothing. Leo the Leader leads the way into the Wipeout Zone. Heat 2. Leo will be glad he doesn't have to go through all this nonsense again. Right. Prepare for the incoming luggage. Oh, nasty. They're starting off with the heavy stuff. Ow. It's just annoying. Ow! Excess baggage gets Tom. Such accuracy, right between the shoulder blades. Tricky shot. But they're all up again. And here come the fickle fingers. Bunny Boy Daniel springs over. Ish, and now they're all dropping again. Just Phil and Daniel still in this, but Phil's sliding. Come on, and he's out. Which means Daniel is through to the Wipeout Zone. And Leo's devastated for Silly Philly as Daniel nabs that second spot. But there's still the final heat to go. It's do or die time. But hopefully not the latter. That's a lot of paperwork.
The only one thing worse than Terror Go Round is a wet Terror Go Round.
Oh, well, there goes the last of my duty-free. I really am going to need a refund. Auntie Margaret's hold-all hits Phil. The Terror Twins really are ruthless today.
I can't take it seriously.
You should, because here come the fickle fingers. Maya's down. Well, they all are. Hang on. Maya's back on her feet, and they're all going through the punch bags. But it's the last one standing to go through. Let's take another look at that. Well, things got highly chaotic in that final heat. They were all knocked down, but last on her feet was Mad Scientist Maya. So well done, Maya. She joins Leo and Daniel in the Wipeout Zone. Commiserations to Nick, Phil and Tom. Tom the Viking. He came to pillage, but his voyage ends here. Silly Philly was tough, but took one too many beatings. And Nickodactyl must finally lay his fossils to rest in Argentina. Hard luck, guys.
All right, I'll give it a quick go. Wow, what a hammered inserts name of game here. My, didn't hammered inserts name of contestant here do well? I think the smart money's on hammered inserts name of favourite contestant. This is just rehearsal, right? I mean, you're going to put real words in. I don't want to look a fool on national television.
What? Where are those for the next bit? All right.
Next, it's the Wipeout Zone. When do we do this for real? Can I have a coffee?
The reason why Leo applied was really because he hasn't seen many deaf people on TV and he wanted to be the first to try the Wipeout.
Being in the Wipeout Zone, I don't know what to say. I mean, there is only three of us left. How did I get here? I think it's by pure luck.
When I first got told I was on the show, it was a little overwhelming, if I'm honest, but I've got nothing to lose as far as I'm concerned.
I'm very, very proud of Leo. He's done really, really well. And yeah, you did beat me in everything.
Being last woman standing? Hello. My children, they will be so proud.
She's the underdog in all this, you know? I was so made up for her to get through.
Dan, he's very determined. He's a little bit clumsy, though.
Leo is amazing. He's cruised through everything.
He was fastest and obviously the fittest.
He's very, very nervous. He's saying that he needed the toilet every 10 minutes before each game.
Each round I get further, it's just more happiness, a better shot at the title. Until I've been beaten, I don't see any reason not to back myself.
I'm very worried, but at the end of the day, I was worried about every other course and I managed, so I'm gonna win this! I am, why not? Watch me.
If he wins, he'll feel very happy. Looking forward to coming back and win the big final.
I've got goosebumps, and not just because there's a storm brewing, but because we've got an extremely exciting Wipeout Zone, and Maya is the first to brave it.
Mad scientist Maya becomes today's first guinea pig.
Go! Here she goes!
So Maya gets things started on a wet and stormy night in Buenos Aires. And that rain means that the obstacles are wetter than usual. Maya gets to the rapid climb, which is always pretty wet. She's up, so the 10-second tidal wave countdown has begun. Oh, this isn't good. That giant wave is imminent. Here it comes.
Oh, no, hang on, Maya, with those fuzzy arms!
Well, Maya is hanging on, but this will slow her down. Seesaw of truth, and it is extra slippery tonight. Maya wisely taking it easy. Better to be cautious and avoid a slip. Safely over. So now onto a drenched, crazy sweeper. Maya, pausing, prepares herself. Choosing a moment. Ducks! And is up again. Not a lot of grip up there in these conditions. Oh, it's clipped her! But she's up and away, skipping over the podiums. Oh, yes, fantastic stuff from Maya. Onto the first turntable now. Lines herself up for the jump. Here we go. Oh no! Mad scientist Maya's jumping experiment went all wrong there. She's gonna feel that. She'll have to heave herself back up for the next jump. Exhausted, looking a bit wobbly. Only one jump to go. Oh, that won't help. Maya must be getting dizzy now. This is desperate. Here she goes. Oh, she's down again.
Oh no! She didn't.
She did. Again, well short of her target. The umbrella-wielding crowd urge Maya back up. Surely she can't fall again. Yes! Well, some amazing determination from Maya. She made it all the way to the Wipeout Zone, but the stormy weather took its toll on her run time. But she finished.
Come on out, my darling. How are you feeling?
Not good. This is so hard.
You did that in 5 minutes and 1 second. It's not the worst in the world.
You sure?
Daniel's up next. Let's watch.
Can the bunny boy hop his way to victory?
Believe!
Yes, believe! But also remember to swim. So Maya's time of 5 minutes and 1 second is now the benchmark for Daniel. But he doesn't know that, he'll just be going as fast as he can.
Come on, Danny!
Great sportswomanship from Maya there, and Daniel's charging up the rapid climb. Woo! He's beaten the tidal wave, So now it's that unusually slippy seesaw. Dispatched. Apparently with ease, no problem for Daniel, the crazy sweeper now. Neil's under the arm and Daniel is up and off. Stopped. Another well-timed duck. Here we go. The podium's now. Hurry up. Right. The turntables. This is where things started to fall apart for Maya. But he's on to the first. And no, he's down!
Come on, Dan!
Bunny boy Daniel just didn't get the distance. Direction was a bit off as well. One final jump left for Daniel. Yes, 1 minute, 41 seconds, the bunny boy hops into the lead. He sets the time to beat, but that fall could be costly with Leo, the leader, still to run.
Danny McBee, boy, there was nothing B about that. That was pretty A-game where I was standing.
Oh, well, thank you, Amanda.
But listen, you've been confident that you would smoke that course. Tell you what, Maya, there is no smoke without fire. Because you were faster. I'm sorry, Maya. And you, young man, yours is now the time to beat, but Leo, who's pretty fantastic, is up next.
Still anyone's game.
Let's watch.
Leo, the leader, is locked and loaded. He's doing this for his family and for Phil. Off Leo sets in his bid for £10,000.
Let me know.
I've got a girlfriend among them.
Now, Leo doesn't know Daniel's time, so he'll just have to give it his best. And that is exactly what he's doing. No tidal wave danger for Leo.
That was fast.
Oh, my God. I blinked and I missed that.
This is going to be a close one. Leo is on the rain-soaked seesaw now, again making it look simple. Steps off and approaches the crazy sweeper. Here we go. Oh, no, disaster!
Oh, no, he did not just do that.
Again, he did, yes. Leo got nudged and that tipped him into the extra wet stuff. Oh, it's gonna hurt. But all is not lost. Remember, Daniel made one mistake, so if Leo comes up with a flawless finish now, he is still in with a shot. First jump, success. Can't afford any mistakes now. And it's now the tricky one. Big runner. Yes, the first one to make that today. Next jump. Yes, yes. Is he on? Yes! This is going to the wire now, nearly there. No! No! That is heartbreaking. Having jumped back into contention, that fall has just cost Leo the competition. Leo hauls himself up the ladder. Let's see if he can get it right this time. He does, but 2 minutes free is not enough to topple bunny boy Daniel. Still, what a finish. Poor Leo, he's been a leader throughout, but those unfortunate slips went and cost him the title.
Oh my goodness, Leo, you have been unbeatable all day. You were fastest on the qualifier, you were first on double cross, you were first on terra go round. But you weren't fast enough to beat the B-boy because you, Daniel, are the Total Wipeout champion!
And so today's champion is photographer slash B-boy Daniel Levy from Liverpool. He walks away with that trophy and £10,000. However, he also walks away without his bunny hat. But no fear, I have made him a replacement hat. Don't worry, I'll pop it in the post when I finish with it. Until then, from Amanda and me, it's goodbye.